Welcome to Punarvasi Technologies. www.punarvasi.com is my website. I use it to write different step-by-step procedures on SAP basis administration in this website. Many people got benefited from my articles. My name is Mr. Raz. I am SAP basis NetWeaver international trainer, trained students in more than 50 countries. In this video, I'll show you how to start Oracle database within SAP systems, and then I'll show you how to stop the Oracle database within the SAP system. Here I'm just connecting to my server to demonstrate this experiment using remote desktop connection. MSTSC is the command to connect remote desktop, remote computers, that is remote servers. This is the IP address of my server. And click on the connect button. So right now the user account used is PRDADM, but I'll log in as administrator account first. It is the server operating system, server 2008. Server Windows Server Enterprise. You can also check the version of the server from Win version. WinBar. So here there are many SAP systems are installed. Out of these, development, quality assurance, production. Three systems are installed for the purpose of doing transport management system experiments. Out of these three systems, development and quality already started. That means the database belongs to these two systems are already started. And PRD system is not yet started. If I right click here and click on the start, the database will be started by the SAP itself. Instead of starting database of PRD in this method, I'll just show you how to start the database of PRD using command line tools. To start the PRD database, you need to log in as related user account. Each SAP system will have its own administrator account. So you can find out the user accounts from computer, right click. Click on the manage. From the configuration, click on the local users and groups, expand it, click on the users. So these are all the different user accounts available in this particular server. Out of these user accounts, PRDADM is related to the production system. So that you have to log into the SAP system, log into the server using PRDADM user account to start the database. So just log off from here. Login as PRDADM. Use another account. PRD media and its password. The main purpose to log in as related administrator account is for this particular user, the environment variables of Oracle database are already configured. When you install, while installation only, the variables, that is environment variables, are already configured. That is DBMS underscore type or a DBS underscore vara underscore schema is SAP SR3. DBS underscore vara underscore TNS name is, that is SID, system identifier, is PRD. Like that, all the environment variables are related to this particular database are already configured, so that you have to log in as the PRD administrator account, that is SAP administrator. Okay, Oracle underscore SID is PRD. So as you have already environment variables here, that's why you can directly go to command prompt to log on to the Oracle database using SQL plus slash no log, means without logging in the command will be executed. You will get the SQL prompt here like this, SQL greater than. From here just type the command connect slash as sysdba. Okay, it is connected to an idle instance. Now you need to start the database using command start start up. So it will allocate the system global area like this, and the database will be mounted, and then the database will be opened. So once the database is mounted and opened, you can directly start the SAP system. Means when you start the SAP system, again it will not start the database. Directly the SAP system will be started. So database is open. Now you can start your SAP system using SAP Management Console. Click on the continue. Click on OK. The development and quality assurance already started using administrator account. So here right click and click on the start to start the production system. Click on the OK and provide the password of the administrator account, that is PRDADM account. So you have to wait for some time to get this system up. Click on the refresh button. So here without starting database, directly it is starting the related SAP services. See, it is little bit faster also because the database is already started. You need to get all status wait and start as. Like this. Okay, it is almost started. You can log on to the SAP system using SAP log on icon from the desktop. PRD. Still starting. Okay, maybe the IP address is different. Click on the properties, NW7EHP1, right? NW7EHP1, yes, it is correct. So let us check the IP address also. It sometimes it may not communicate properly with the host names. IP config. What's the IP address of this? 2.6. So that you can replace this with 192.168.2.6. Like this. Okay, SAP star and the password. You should get the SAP easy access screen so that you can confirm that your SAP system is working perfectly. That means the PRD system is working perfectly. Now once it is logged in, just it is SAP easy access screen, just log off, testing is over. And now right click here and click on the stop. This stop will not stop the database, just it will stop the SAP system only. That means the central instance of this particular SAP system will be stopped. Only one central instance is there, no dialog instances are installed for the PRD system, only the central instance. You can also right click here and click on the stop. That means the instance of this particular system will be stopped. Okay, because you don't have any other instances, dialog instances like development system, directly you can right click on PRD and click on the stop button to stop the SAP instance. Click on OK.
So this is SAP system, this is SAP instance. In the development system, this is the SAP system. Of this SAP system, this is the central instance of development system. This is the dialog instance of the development system. If you right click here and click on the stop, all the instances of this particular development system will be stopped. If you right click on the particular instance, right click and click on the stop, that particular instance will be stopped without stopping other instances. But you have to stop all the dialog instances to stop the central instance. Okay, the production system is stopped. It is gray color. That means the SAP instance is stopped. Now, if you try to shut down the database, like I am exiting from here, again I will log into the Oracle using SQL plus slash no log and connect slash as sys dba. So because the Oracle database is already started, that's why it is saying that connected. It is not saying that connected to idle instance. But suppose if you try to start up again, what it will say? Cannot start already running Oracle. Shut it down first. You have to shut down. So shut down is the command. Shut down immediately it will be stopped. Shut down immediate. Okay. Once it is shut down, the database of the production system will be completely stopped. So once it is stopped, if you try to start the SAP system directly from here, what it will do? It will start the database first, then the SAP system will be started. Like you see, Oracle instance shutdown, database is dismounted and database closed. So now if I right click here and click on the start button, first what it will do, it will start the Oracle database from here. You see SAP CPE.exe, it will start the database of this particular system. So I hope you understood about starting and stopping from command prompt using SQL slash no log. If you have any questions on this particular experiment, you can leave your comments under this video, or you can also use my website to send me messages. Just let us look at here and get back. Yes, you see it is started already. Okay. So thanks for watching.